So hello everybody, this is Alfred from TwinSim, and today I have an unboxing video of the G1000 Bezel from Simionic. Actually it's a double feature unboxing because to get this to run we need to unbox an iPad, because the Simionic is, as I said before, just a bezel that comes to be a simulated G1000 unit when we plug in the iPad. Talking about the Simionic delivery, the parcel shipped absolutely well. Has arrived about 3 days after I ordered it in China. It was dispatched right the next day, so excellent shipping. So let's have a look inside. Here we go. All right. So here we are. This is more or less a one-to-one retention of a real G1000. It comes with a manual and USB cable. Here we have bezel, and here we find two stands and even a kit with necessary screws and tools. So very neat. So what can we say about this solution in advance, because this is not going to be a review, more or less. It's just an unpacking. If there's interest from your side, I will be glad to find the time and make a review of it. So it is, I think, an injected plastic on the front, and it's in a metal housing at the back. Here you see the USB power that then afterwards needs to be connected to supply both the bezel and the iPad that is in the housing then. And here's another external port. I do believe it is going to be used maybe for the audio panel that will be out soon. On the side we find the screws and the nuts, so more or less they look absolutely like the real thing and needs to be opened to be mounted to either now housing, like in my case, or you just use it with the stand that is packed here. So it has some soft parts that are going to keep the iPad in place and away from scratching. And here, this is something interesting. We have like four distance holder caps, or how should we call them? And it's interesting because the producer allowed for different sizes of iPads that you can put into this housing. And we will see afterwards how this will look like. For you to get an idea how this unit combines with the iPad, I just open up the toolkit, and what I'm doing now is I open up the little screws that are here to get, okay, this is not the right tool, but this should be it, okay, yeah, and it's tight, so. So that's basically it, and now I remove the metal casing. Here we see these distance bolts, and I removed the screw from the back. So I have to mount it differently than it was here before. And here we can compare it. So here it is in the large holes, here in the small, and it gives a slightly different distance. And what I do now is I put the screw back in. So, and I'm doing this now 4 times. So here we are, this work has to be done just once, and also it looks a little flimsy, it's a very nice idea and it shows how much detail was put into producing this bezel. Okay, that's basically the most important step, and now we can have a look before we close it at the inside part. So here you see the area where the iPad slides in. You see the encoders here. Try to get this better onto camera. And the boards with backlighting holding the push buttons. Here you see where the original cable of the iPad connects. We will do this in a second. Here we're going to pull up the remaining cable to have it stowed, and yeah, basically that's the whole unit. So looks solid, it's made in plastic, and I have had the possibility to sit in an aircraft within G1000 recently, and I mean, you will see in the end, it absolutely gives the impression that you have a real unit in your fingers. So I'm eager to put the iPad in. As it concerns the iPad, you need, as said before, a unit with a 9.7 diameter. You better take one with space gray or especially black frame, because you're going to see the black frame in the end, and it's not going to look nice if you take one with a white one. That's not just an opinion, that's really something that I strongly recommend to do. Okay, and now you have to check where is the opening for the cable, and yeah, now we just slide it in. And until it fits softly. That's it. So now we have an iPad fixed in this opening. Next step is going to be implement the cable. So we're gonna take this from here. You can take the original one, of course. And what we need is to plug in the cable here, and if it doesn't work, you can take like a tool, just, and here we go, cable is in. And now we make sure the cable is sitting nicely in the bezel. There's of course a much nicer way to do that, because you can really, like in the manual, put it exactly nice looking here at this three cord holders, but it takes time, so I just want to give you an idea, and that's the reason I'm speeding up here a little. When you're doing like this, you have to be sure when you put the metal casing back on That's the four distance holders. Do not get some problems with the cable that is lying now loosely. And last thing to do is put the six screws back on again. And so the work is done, and we are finished with our unit. It can now be mounted into the panel, and it's hardly to be seen that there's an iPad in this unit, so it really looks like the real deal to me. And yeah, how to wake it up? First of all, I need to plug in the power cord to give it electricity. So the unit wakes up and we have an iPad here. So, and we just can go into the G1000 app. So the better see it, I just better get down the lights here. Overall feeling impression is just great, and I mean it feels like the real thing, and it's really a piece of art, I have to say. And I'm very happy to be one of the, I think, few customers who already got their hands on such a unit. As far as I know, about 100 units have been produced already, and especially the combination with an app, and giving me the chance to put away one of my computers that was running recently, a Flight One Tech G1000, should speed up, make things easier in my setup, and remove hassle that I had before. So, last thing to do is let's see how two units look like and how to wake up this. So this pretty much completes my video. I hope you liked it. If you have further questions, please contact me in the comment field below. Have a nice day.